back in God's house. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's just stand in the presence of God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And it is so good to have our leaders back. It is so good to have Bishop Flowers back. And of course, his beautiful wife, Sister Sharon Flowers back. Pastor Flowers is good. It is so good to have you all back. I actually thought you all got caught up. I said, it's so cold in New York. I said, they must have got caught up in all that cold and couldn't get back. But I thank God because you know what? We were in place. That's all we said. We said, all we need to do is be in place. And I think that's all God looking to be in place. Amen. We welcome you all back. It is so good. Hallelujah. To have our leaders back. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. And I thank God for the leaders that we have. Hallelujah. I do. Hallelujah. I always say, you know, I know, Pastor. I know he hears from God. Hallelujah. And it is so important that you know the leader that you're under hears from God. Because there's many voices out there. Many voices out there. But I know he hears from God. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. We're going to go into the scripture. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord God. Hallelujah. God is so worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. You know, there's so much things going on. There's a young man that got killed just before I read the scripture. And he got shot, 32. And Brother Jeff said to me, he's only one key one I know in Cable Beach. He said, I hope that's not him. And sure enough, when we got to obituary, that was him. But when I met this young man 2 years ago, he said to me, he said, your mother used to teach me in Sunday school. So he knew about Jesus. I don't think he was saved. Because you sometimes from people's actions and what they're into, you know whether they're serving and things of God. But he knew. And God gives everybody an opportunity. And today is not like years ago. Years ago, you know, you could have, 50, 60 years ago, you could have fooled around and still make it into heaven. And you live long and you give your life. But today, the enemy is just cutting down left, right, and center. You cannot take a chance. You can't even say, I'm going to backslide and make it back. Because you can sit now and the enemy right there to cut you down. And it's a time when God is so serious and the enemy is so serious. But God is serious also. Hallelujah, hallelujah. That was so sad to hear. Hallelujah. But he knew because he was taught in Sunday school. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We're going to go into the book of Matthew chapter 5 before we open in a word of prayer. And this is dealing with the Beatitudes. And Jesus is speaking here. Hallelujah. Jesus is speaking. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. I'm going to give you a minute to find Matthew chapter 5. Hallelujah. It is so good to be back among God's people, to be back in his house. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I love the people of God. Hallelujah. I don't love the devil people because there's some wicked people in this world. There are some wicked people, hallelujah, there are some wicked people in this world. So let me tell you, the voice of God people better than the devil people.
That's right.
What we will say, the worst of God's people. Yeah. I prefer to be around that have some God consciousness, that have some love of God. Even if they're slipping and sliding, sometimes they don't do the thing, but they have a God consciousness than to be around wicked people that have no sense of God, fear God nor man. I prefer to be around the people of God. Hallelujah. Matthew chapter 5. And seeing the multitudes, he went into a mountain. And when he was set, his disciples came unto him. And he opened his mouth and taught them, saying, blessed are the poor in spirit, for there is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. Blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are ye when men shall revile you and persecute you and shall say all manner of evil against you falsely for my sake. Rejoice and be exceeding glad, for great is your reward in heaven. For so persecuted they the prophets which were before you. Thank you, hallelujah. That's a lot of blessing.
Yes.
That's a lot of blessing, hallelujah.
Amen.
Poor in spirit, humble. Those that mourn, you know, sometimes we cry in the night and we say, Lord, we don't understand. But he said, you shall be confident, not maybe.
Yes.
Blessed are the meek, those that keep a quiet spirit. Those that when you sometimes you feel like opening your mouth and saying, let me just close my mouth, you know. Sometimes you have to tell yourself that.
Yes.
And those who hunger and thirst after righteousness. You know when you're hungry?
Yes.
And you say, man, boy, I'm so hungry and I'm so thirsty, what I want to do. That's what Jesus said. After righteousness. After righteousness. For they shall be filled. Amen. God will never leave you and you hunger after and merciful. For they shall obtain mercy. Looking on others with mercy. People that you see on the street having mercy upon. I know sometimes we look at me, we want, but merciful. Having an attitude of mercy and the pure in heart. There is so much evil on the internet and around us. You have to try to keep your mind pure. Keep your heart pure. Bless it. And you don't need to see everything. You don't even need to hear something. Something says, you know, I don't want to hear. And I wonder, there one time I had a teacher, she said to me, she said, oh, Miss Larkin, I'm like, yes. Say, you ever watch this show? I said, what show? I'm trying to figure out what the show is. But this is a show about two lesbian women. And she want to put a knife. I said, no, 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 I don't want to see that. I don't want to see that. And I said to myself, my God, supposed to be a child of God. But I just watch them and see, excuse me? What you watching for? Pure. I don't want to say, I think things I didn't want to hear. I don't want to hear. Keep your heart pure, your mind peace. Peace. Be someone that's spread peace. Don't say anything. If you know it's going to cause the corruption, keep your mouth quiet. If you know one employee tell you something about the boss, don't go tell the boss that she say that. He, no. Keep it to yourself. Sometimes I hear my boss complain to me about this teaching, the teacher saying this thing. I don't say nothing to either. I may not agree, but I'm not going to cause trouble. Blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for there's the kingdom of, you know, we don't know much about persecution. We didn't get killed. You know, all the apostles got killed. All the apostles, except for John. And they attempted three times to kill John. They were persecuted. They got whipped. They were crucified upside down. The bit of persecution we get is we don't want the world to see me serving Jesus. And we feel shame. And we call that persecution. And we know nothing but bless it. If you are persecuted and for righteousness sake, standing up for what's right. You know the judge? I was so proud in America when that judge refused to marry those two couples because of what she believed. And there's a young man that wrote, I have to say this, he wrote in a newspaper. He's homosexual. I feel very sorry for him. The reason I feel sorry for him, he said he cries himself asleep at night. So he says that, you know, the Christians are saying he's going to hell and God don't love him. And I'm like, you know, Christians, we're not saying that. We are not saying that. We are saying God loves you. He sent his son to die. But if we, and that includes us, if you're fornicated, man and woman sleeping together, if you're not married, you're on your way to hell if you don't repent. If you're married and you commit adultery, having another man on your husband and having another woman, if you die, you're going to hell. We're saying if you're a murderer and you kill people, if you die and you don't repent, you're going to hell. If we don't repent of our sins, we are Christians going to hell. We are not saying that God don't love you. All we're saying is that God loves you so much. He wants you to live a life that's holy and pure. He wants you to come and be in his heaven. That is not what we are saying. We're not, we know God doesn't discriminate against anybody, you know. God said, for God so loved the world. That's no discrimination. God so loved the world that he sent his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish. Whosoever, that's no discrimination. It doesn't matter how you look. It doesn't matter what color you are. It doesn't matter what lifestyle. God is saying, I don't want you to perish. Come to me and let me cleanse you of his sin. Hallelujah. 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 God loves everybody, but we all need to be saved. We all need to be washed in the blood of the Lamb. Hallelujah. We're going to go into prayer. Open up in a word of prayer. Hallelujah. I want even the children to stand. Hallelujah. Give God respect. Hallelujah. My son was reading the scriptures and said, we're making them read the Bible. It was the part that said, they that worship and shall worship in spirit and in truth. And Father, seek in such ways. You worship in God in spirit and truth. He said, no, mommy. I'm not. I said, at least you know. I said, but you know you need to pray God that you really learn. He teaches you and help you worship him in spirit and in truth. Hallelujah. Let's just bow in a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we come before you, Lord. We come before you humbly, Lord God of hosts. We come before you acknowledging that you are God. We come before you, O God, Heavenly Father, acknowledging that we are nothing without you. O Lord God of hosts, we thank you so much for the precious blood of Jesus Christ that was shed on Calvary. We thank you, Heavenly Father, that you loved us so much that you want to take us from a life of sin, O God, and place us into your kingdom where we walk before you in holiness and in righteousness. O Heavenly Father, we thank you that you want to give us good success and expected end. O Heavenly Father, we thank you that you want us to live life and have life more abundantly. O God, we just praise and we just magnify you. Father, we realize that the thief coming not to but kill, steal, and destroy, and that's what he's doing in so many lives. But O Lord God, you are mighty to save. You are strong to deliver. O Heavenly Father, we just give praise and we give glory unto you. We just magnify the name of Jesus Christ. O Father, we thank you that in the name of Jesus, oh God, Heavenly Father, salvation is wrought. In the name of Jesus Christ, deliverance will come. In the name of Jesus Christ, we are healed and we are delivered. And by his blood, we are saved from destruction, oh God. Oh Heavenly Father, we just magnify the name of Jesus. We declare that he's our King, he's our Lord, he's our Savior and our Master and our Redeemer. Oh God, we just humble ourselves under your mighty hand. Heavenly Father, we rejoice in you this morning because you are the Lord our God. We thank you that you are our deliverer. Oh Heavenly Father, we give glory and we give honor unto your name. Heavenly Father, we thank you that we are sitting in heavenly places in thee, far above all principalities and powers. Oh Heavenly Father, we thank you that you've given us our power of the enemy, and therefore, Lord God of hosts, we exercise every power and authority that's given unto us through the name of Jesus Christ, and we pull down strongholds in the name of Jesus Christ. We dash down and silence principalities right now in the name of Jesus Christ. We ask you to dispatch heavenly hosts, Lord God of hosts, the chain Lucifer on the demon god and demons that are on assignment against the people of God in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, and we made them subject to the Lordship of Christ. Father, we come against their work and we push back the kingdom of darkness. We'll not prevail against the people of God, neither against his church. Oh God in heaven, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Father, we stand upon your word. We ask you that the sword of the Lord will go forth and devour the enemy and will not draw back. Lord God of hosts, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Heavenly Father, we thank you because we stand victorious, because you said the gates of hell will never prevail against your church. Therefore, Lord God of hosts, we magnify you because you are God. We magnify and we glorify your holy name. Father, we commit this service into your hand. Lord God Almighty, we thank you for the anointing and the power of your spirit that will ready upon your man of God. Now, O Heavenly Father, we ask you to release the double portion, O God, in Heavenly Father, upon him in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, because we know that thou, O God, want to do great and marvelous things in the midst of your people. O Lord God, we just worship and we just adore you. We ask you to have your way. Bless your hearts and your people, O God, in Heavenly Father. We ask you to touch us in a special way. Move in this service in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We glorify and we worship you, O God, never the Father. We give you praise and glory and honor this morning, O God. Father, we commit, O God, all things into your hands, because you are a God that liveth and reigneth forever and ever, and of your kingdom there is no end. Now, Lord God, receive all the praises, the glory, and the honor that's only due unto your holy name, and we magnify the name of Jesus Christ. And Holy Ghost, we commit this service into your hands, that, oh God, the will of God